Welcome to the Tech Race. Is the posture of weightlifters just as important as their strength? Even the most powerful athletes rely on technology to prevent injury and improve performance. In weightlifting, execution and motion is given great importance. However, posture is just as essential. Coaches and medical staff rely on a combination of motion capture and force platforms to analyze athletes and push them to improve, all whilst trying to avoid injury. In Seoul, the Korean Institute of Sport Science is pioneering the investigation of these biomechanical platforms.
지금 일단 이제 요즘에 이제 발전되는 추이가 이제 동작 분석을 하게 되면 이 동작 분석 기술은 1980년대부터 주로 시작을 했습니다. 그리고 기본적으로는 카메라 이제 영상 스틸 촬영을 많이 했는데 2000년도 넘어서 들어서서는 이제 인프라 적외선 카메라가 개발이 되면서 이제 바로 실시간으로 동작을 분석해낼 수 있는 그런 시스템으로 이제 발전되어 온 겁니다.
Force platforms and motion sensing infrared cameras reveal data that can determine the correct bar path, time, and force spent in each part of the exercise, in addition to body posture. These markers allow the system to recreate a 3D digital image of the weightlifter's body that, when combined with the force platforms, offers information about the amount of force exerted on which muscles, joints, and bones. This technology lets athletes and their trainers alike know the amount of strength they are using, as well as their potential for improvement. The athlete steps onto the platform and lifts weights as normal. The information from the force platforms and motion capture is combined and analyzed by the system. Weightlifters and coaches alike can review technique and see where there is room for improvement once the athlete is finished, presenting crucial data about the athlete's performance that could not be analyzed without this cutting-edge technology.
10kg 따지면은 한 5kg 정도. 언밸런스 나게. 그래서 요거 한번 더 해볼게요.
This system can detect asymmetries in muscle strength as well as bad posture. 120 years before these tests were developed, in Olympic Games Athens 1896, the first weightlifting competition took place in a field. Since Antwerp 1920, weightlifting has been an Olympic discipline, but only for men. Women were first allowed to take part in Sydney 2000. Yang Miran, Olympic gold medalist, Beijing 2008, is one of the athletes who has benefited from this technology. She trained at the Korean Institute of Sports and Science to prevent further physical ailment. Successfully, she surely won't be the last.